Hello, I'm Dr. Nimal Gamage. My topic today is don't stay fat. Most people seem to be very comfortable staying overweight or fat, and they don't seem to understand that there's a grave damage done to their bodies every day they stay fat. And these are statistics which we all need to know, and also now we know for sure why people get fat and how we can avoid being fat. Therefore, there's no reason for anybody to stay fat and damage themselves and die early, get cancer, get heart disease, get Alzheimer's, and even get things like depression, arthritis, and myriads of other diseases. 50 years ago, it used to be just 1 in 8 or 9 Americans who got obese, but today it's 1 in 3, and in fact two of three people, that is more than 66% of the people today in United States, are considered overweight. And also we know that children are getting fatter, adolescents are getting fatter, and even newborn babies, which is quite a new thing, are getting fatter. And it has become a big epidemic, and the doctors think it's calories in and calories out. You just have to eat less and you won't be fat. But the medical science has proven beyond doubt that it's not calories in and out. It's not how much you eat, but it's what you eat which makes you fat. And that's what I'm going to talk about in this lecture. And what makes us accumulate fat is basically the hormone insulin. When your insulin goes up, it makes your fat cells accumulate fat. And insulin goes down, it makes your fat cells dissolve the fat and release the fatty acids into circulation to be used by, for energy purposes, by other tissues. And these facts were known since 1960s and had never been controversial. And what determines the insulin level? It is determined entirely by how much carbohydrate we eat. So you eat carbohydrate, your insulin goes up, you get fat. And these are things the doctors had ideas about this for centuries. And these were all changed in 1960s and 70s because of one person who came and said it's all saturated fat, it's all fat. But now we know it's not true. It's not the fat which makes you fat, it's the carbohydrates. And I'm going to go through this based on the medical studies which have been done through the last century. And here's a person who has a condition where she gets fat only below the waist. And there are people who has this condition, and we call it a fat lipodystrophy, condition of lipodystrophy, where some areas of the body does not retain extra fat, but one half of the body can retain all your fat. And here's pretty much another structure showing that estrogen is another hormone other than the insulin which creates fat in the cells. And that is because when a woman gets pregnant, she needs to store extra fat, extra energy in the body for her fetus, for the baby. And so anything you do to increase estrogen will make you fat. You lower the estrogen and you lose fat. So they all work through an enzyme called lipoprotein lipase, insulin as well as estrogen, to make you fat or make you thin. And why do men get fat in the tummy whereas women get fat in other areas? Because men has their lipoprotein lipase activity higher in the gut, inside the abdomen. So when men get fat, they put the fat inside the abdomen. I mean, I'm a cosmetic surgeon, and a lot of men call me asking, can I remove my fat with a liposuction? Simple answer is no, you can't. For men, the fat is what you call visceral fat, is inside the abdomen. When a person who is like 7 to 8 kilos and they're supposed to be 50, if you come to a doctor like me, we can only remove 0.5 to 1 kilogram of fat which is under the skin. But today, we know the fat under the skin is the healthy fat which creates a good kind of hormones and make you healthy. And if you remove that, you only become unhealthy and you leave all the fat inside the body which makes you unhealthy, so you become even sicker. So, surgery is not your solution, unfortunately. So what is the solution? So on a daily basis, this lipase activity goes up and down based on the insulin. So when you had a good meal, for example, your lipase activity starts working and fat away in storage, especially if you ate carbohydrate. Now in the night or when you're working out, lipase activity goes down on the surface of the cells, and there's another lipase inside the cells which releases the fat out of the fat stores, or we call it adipose tissues, into the body, so it can be utilized as energy. So insulin has another effect on this other lipase inside the cells called hormone sensitive lipase. We call it HSL for short. And so it works just like the lipoprotein lipase, but the HSL works to make fat cells thinner. So it's the one which releases the fat. And so when the insulin is low, it works hard. Insulin is high, it works less. And it makes the fat break down into triglycerides, from triglycerides into fatty acids, which get released into circulation and gets used up by the muscles or your brain as energy. Then there are other hormones other than insulin and estrogen, and all these hormones usually make you lose fat. For example, adrenaline is pumped when you are in a flight or fight situation, when you're excited or you're scared, and this adrenaline will help you to release fat from the fat tissue so you can use it for the emergency you have on hand. Similarly, cortisol also usually, except for cortisol, I was going to say similarly, but except for cortisol usually makes you fat. So that's why it's easier for you to get fat if you're under a lot of stress. It would probably make you very hungry too. Cortisol makes you hungry, especially for the carbohydrates. So if you're already addicted to carbohydrate food, you like the sugar and the starchy foods, when you're under stress, your body will make you eat them in high quantities. So basically, insulin makes you fatter. So how do you stay thin? You have to stop eating carbohydrates and the sugar. That's the bottom line. It's as simple as that. So if somebody wants to lose weight, you have to lose the carbohydrates. And you also know that little children who are born today are usually fatter at the age of 6 months. Why? Because most people are now eating a lot of carbohydrates. And that's why. So it's not their genes. So obesity is not a genetic problem. It's a problem of what you eat. And so a baby who is born fat usually is born with a lot of fat in the body. And also they over-secrete insulin when they get older. So they get insulin resistance, condition called insulin resistance. They get obesity much easier than a baby who has been born thinner. So it's very important for people to make sure that when a person is pregnant, that pregnant lady does not eat too much carbohydrates and make a fat baby. Otherwise, that person's entire life is affected. That person will have a shorter life. That person will get diabetes, high blood pressure, cancer, and probably die early. So being fat is no fun. And there's no reason to stay fat, because all the facts we need to know about how to stay thin and make sure that obesity is eradicated is already here. We just need to know the facts. Then again, there are some foods which have carbohydrates, but they are not really fattening. That's also important, because for example, if you eat rice is fattening. Doesn't matter what kind of rice you eat. If you eat wheat, anything made of wheat flour, it's more fattening than rice. It's probably about 5 or 6 times more fattening because wheat flour is thoroughly processed and all the fiber has been taken out. 80% of the fiber in the wheat has been taken out, so it becomes digested into sugar very quickly. Also, sugar is probably the most fattening thing on earth. Nobody should be eating any sugar. Sugar is not only fattening, it causes and leads to all the diseases, including cancer, heart disease, strokes, Alzheimer's, and so on. So anybody who wants to stay healthy should not be taking any sugar. Also, we know today that in rich countries, it's the poor people who are getting fat. Why? Because rich people are usually conscious about their body. They have bigger egos, so they try to stay thin or stay looking good. So they usually get help, they do exercises, and they try to cut down on their food. Whereas poor people who eat just because they are hungry have to buy the cheapest food available for them, and the cheapest food usually are the carbohydrate foods. They are produced in very high quantities, so they are eating, they have a high carb diet. Although they are eating just to alleviate their hunger, they get fatter because they are eating more carbohydrates, and they don't have a choice because foods without carbohydrates are very expensive, so they can't afford it. And that's why when you go to US or UK or any developed country, you see that poor people who don't have much to live on are actually very fat and are full of diseases. And then again, now there are industries, food industries, sugar industries. They produce a large amount of sugar. People take about 200 times the sugar they took before the last century. They took less than 100 times what they are taking today. And these industries make sure that people don't know these same facts I'm talking to you about. They try to make sure to put so many ads, get children exposed to start eating biscuits and ice cream and cakes, things like that. Make sure people get addicted so they have high profits in the industries. They control the governments, and the governments who are supposed to let people know, make policy, make a policy about nutrition, policy about health, and they're bought by the industry, so they're never going to correct this. So we have to find out the facts and do it for ourselves. Nobody's going to help you. Nobody's going to help you to stay healthy. Again, alcohol. Alcohol is a toxic poison, but obviously nobody's going to stop it. And we live in countries, especially Sri Lanka is the alcohol capital of the world. And we see a lot of people dying from alcohol-related diseases, including cirrhosis, including getting fat, getting heart disease, cancer, strokes. But people are not scared to take it, unfortunately. And so, like I said earlier, it's all about insulin, all about carbohydrates. And sometimes you see thin people who are eating just normal food like other people. But you have to remember that these people who are staying thin are doing running or exercises. When they run, what they also do is they cut down what they're eating. So they eat less. And that's how they stay thin. If you see somebody thin but they are eating carbohydrates, that's the reason for that. But if the same people did not eat carbohydrates, they didn't have to run so much to stay thin. Remember, if there are some people who do a lot of exercise but they are fat and they can't lose weight, they do exercise for a while, then give up, and after a while then they get fat again. And it's known that no diet works, because nobody eats a diet without carbohydrates. So when these diets we talk about, there's always carbohydrates, and so that's why all the diets work short for a short while, and then it just comes right back. The obesity is very hard to cure unless you avoid and completely avoid carbohydrates. And many of the food we have today have been only available to human beings for the past few hundred years, But you know, humanoids have been living here for more than 2 million years. And out of those 2 million years, only 8% of the time they didn't eat this much carbohydrate. They in fact had very little carbohydrates to eat. And initially, we know people of the earth, million years ago or more than 2 million years ago, humanoids, they ate only plant matter. They didn't eat any meat. They were like chimpanzees. And this plant matter was really very low in carbohydrates. Then they were high in fiber and they stayed very thin. They had to work hard to get this food. Then after a while all the rainfall became less and the trees and the plantation became less and less, so people became hunter-gatherers. There they started eating meat. They started to kill animals and eat. Then about 10,000 years ago, that's about the right time I think we started the agriculture, and again people had so much food to eat, so population increased, and that's how our culture started. Our civilization today is based on agriculture. Then if you look at the data, you see that the lifestyle or American diet is causing breast cancer. Breast cancer is the commonest cancer of women. And if you look at the people in Japan, they have one of the lowest breast cancers on earth. But these Japanese people, when they move to US, they get the same rate of breast cancer as the American. The only explanation is because they start eating the American diet. They start eating more sugar. And also, the old populations, rural populations, always have very little cancer on earth, wherever you go. That's because they don't eat sugar, they don't eat flour. And in fact, we know when people get westernized or industrialized, the first food which reaches them is sugar and flour, because that's very easy to transport with trade. And those are the first foods they reach these people. And so that's when they start getting cancers. And then there are people like Inuits. They had to live on seals, caribou and whale meat, so they were only eating animal foods, but they did not have cancer while they were eating animal foods. They only got cancer when they started eating sugar and flour. Then the western diseases like blood pressure, cancer, heart disease, everything started for them. So today, still the doctors tell you it's the cholesterol which causes heart disease, but the facts, medical facts, are not proving it. Medical facts are proving it's not the cholesterol, it's the sugar, it's the carbohydrates, it's the flour, that's what causes heart disease. So the most reliable collaboration called Cochrane Collaboration, they are the one who investigated all the medical studies, and they did assess all the studies which were done. They went through 27 clinical trials through the entire medical literature dating back to even 1950s, and they found only 27 well conducted clinical trials. And after going through all that, they could not make any judgment that changing the fat content of a diet can prevent heart attacks. So changing the eating the fat is not how you can stop heart attacks. That's not the way. And so after all these studies, modification of the fat, not eating saturated fat or eating more monounsaturated or polyunsaturated fat, does not have any effect on heart diseases. So in women, for example, HDL is mostly correlated with the risk of heart disease. And HDL goes up if you stop eating carbs, it goes down if you start eating carbs. It's as simple as that. And they have found recently that LDL has two kinds. There's a large LDL particles and there are small ones. Small ones are ones which are causing heart disease. So if you're eating carbohydrates, you produce small LDLs. If you eat fat, you produce large LDLs. Again, all these facts prove that diet, wrong food, is what causes heart disease. And then there was another big study, big collection of studies which were analyzed, and they analyzed four different diets. The Atkins diet, where people ate 20 grams of carbohydrates for the first 2 to 3 months, after that 50 grams. And then there's a traditional diet, we call it a learned diet, lifestyle, exercise, attitudes, relationships and nutrition diet. Calories were restricted, carbohydrates were 55 to 60%, fat is less than 30%, and saturated fat is less than 10%. And this is what the American Heart Association is promoting, that people should eat. Then there is Ornish diet, fewer than 10% of the calories came from the fat, and people on top of that did exercises and did meditation. Then the Zone diet, where 30% of the fat calories came from protein, 40% from carbs, 30% from fat. And these are the results, cumulative results. On Atkins diet, people lost more weight, and they also had lower blood pressure, their HDL was higher, because only reason is because they didn't eat carbs. I'm not saying Atkins diet is the best diet for people. I'm not a promoter of fat. In fact, fat will give your liver a lot of work, especially if you're sick and trying to get healthy. It's best that you take no fat, no sugar, and no salt. I have other lectures which I'm planning to give, and will prove you without a doubt that all these three things we crave in our diet, the fat and the sugar and the salt, are all bad for you. They all cause illnesses. Today I'm only talking about carbs. So I talk about the LDL particles, I'll talk about the HDL in women. And we also know that carbohydrates cause kidneys to reabsorb sodium, and also it causes high uric acid in the body, which we know causes gout and closely associated with obesity, diabetes and high blood pressure. So the insulin also works on your arteries to make them stiff, and insulin also creates atherosclerosis, and these are studied in details and proven beyond doubt. And also, when you have high insulin, you age faster. And so what can we do? What's the best diet we can take? If you're already fat, you should know that you don't have to. You don't have to die early with heart disease, stroke, cancer, and go through many number of years and months of diseases and suffer. Health and supreme health is the most valuable thing in your life. If you have health, you can enjoy life. If you have no health, if you're sick, it doesn't matter if you are a billionaire, you cannot enjoy your life. There's no fun in life without health. So, bottom line is, if you avoid sugar and carbohydrates, you don't have to get fat. On top of that, if you can avoid fat and salt, you don't have to get other diseases either. So definitely avoid sugar, refined carbohydrates. And then for the people who really want to lose weight really fast, you have to know that there are no antioxidants in your diet anymore. Your vegetables grown today have no antioxidants like 1 century ago, and that's what helps you to get cured faster. So you have to take these antioxidants as supplements. Again, you can't get vitamin D3 by going in the sun, so you have to get D3 as a supplement. And the same thing I was going to say, that if you eat animal food, although animal food doesn't make you fat, it causes other diseases, especially the way they make industrial animal food today can increase your estrogen. So although you don't get fat by insulin, you get fat because it gives you estrogen. Therefore, your best diet is no animal foods, and no rice, no wheat, no sugar, no salt, no fat. So it's not hard to do this. In fact, if you are taking this diet, you will live 20 to 30 years longer. You'll have no cancer, no heart disease, no blood pressure, no diabetes. If you have all those, you will actually cure them. If Dr. Max Gerson, who first showed the world that you can cure 50% of the cancers, I'm talking about the late stage cancers, by staying on a sensible diet without salt, sugar or fat. And those days he didn't have antioxidants, so he used to give calf liver juices to people to provide them with the antioxidants. And he also made sure the people ate organic vegetables and took a lot of vegetables in the form of juices. So we can actually do this today. Today we just have all these supplements available to us, so we can supplement an organic vegetable diet with food supplements and stay on without eating refined carbs and carbs from the rice and flour. You can take your carbs from a little bit of legumes like cardamom, mung, garbanzos, mung beans, cowpea. All these beans have a little bit of carbs, and these carbs are harder to digest. They come with fiber, and they also are called alpha amylase, so they're not different from the carbs from the rice or the bread, and they get digested slowly. They don't increase insulin. In fact, you can cure diabetes on a diet which I would prescribe. So remember, being fat brings you heart disease, cancer, strokes, Alzheimer's and many other chronic diseases, and you're sure to have a low immune system and get sick all the time. So if you're looking for the supreme health and you don't want to get old, you don't look old before your right age, there are solutions for us, and you have to look for it and find out, because no government will tell you, and usually many doctors will not even talk about these things.